Hello everybody and welcome to this channel. On this episode I'm going to introduce to you a marvelous tourist attraction in Turkey, so stay tuned. The Blue Mosque, officially known as the Sultan Ahmed Mosque, stands as a testament to historical grandeur of Ottoman era. This imperial mosque is situated in Istanbul, Turkey and was constructed over 8 years during the reign of Sultan Ahmed I. After several centuries, this prominent beloved example of Ottoman architecture still continues to serve its religious purpose and draw a substantial influx of tourists to Turkey. The mosque has a classical Ottoman layout featuring a central dome that envelops the prayer hall. A magnificent courtyard precedes the main structure, which is complemented by 6 minarets. The interior is adorned with myriad colorful tiles and painted floral motifs, predominantly in shades of blue, from which the mosque derives its colloquial name. Additionally, the complex encompasses notable structures such as Sultan Ahmed's tomb and a theological school. The Blue Mosque was included in the UNESCO World Heritage Site list in 1985 under the name of Historical Landmarks of Istanbul. In 1609, Sultan Ahmed I embarked on an ambitious project of constructing a large mosque in Istanbul to seek divine favor. As the first sultan in a line of rulers who had overlooked the construction of an imperial mosque, Sultan Ahmed I faced challenges. The chosen site was previously occupied by Ottoman viziers' palaces, which in turn necessitated a costly expropriation process. On the other hand, there were economic obstacles within the empire that sparked public protests, arguing that construction should solely rely on the spoils of conquest. Despite facing opposition, Sultan Ahmed I proceeded with the project, but tragically, he passed away before its completion. Thus, the mosque's inauguration ceremony occurred under his successor. The building, with its opulence and elaborate public ceremonies, eventually won over public sentiment and became one of the city's most esteemed and visited religious sites. In 1883, significant portions of the mosque's interior decorations underwent replacement and caused the altering of the original color scheme. In 1912, a major fire damaged peripheral structures of the mosque complex that were subsequently reinstated. Notably, the primary restoration of the mosque occurred in the 21st century. During preparatory work in 2013, it was discovered that the northwest minaret had shifted 5 centimeters over time, which prompted the comprehensive renovation in 2015 to ensure structural stability. The mosque's design reflects the early 16th century architecture that features a prayer hall measuring 72 by 64 meters. The central dome, spanning 23.5 meters in diameter, is surrounded by 4 semidomes, each flanked by 3 smaller semidomes. Additional smaller domes cover the hall's corners. In the external section, the mosque has 6 minarets, ablution facilities, and a spacious courtyard. With its imposing size and splendor, the Blue Mosque exemplifies classical Ottoman architectural style of the Islamic era. Noteworthy is the meticulous attention to building details, spatial designs, and the lavish use of tiles, which indicate a trend towards architectural extravagance. The interior part centers on mihrab, minbar, tiles and paintings. The mihrab is located on southeastern side of prayer hall and made of finely carved marble with a muqarnas niche and two inscription panels above it. To the right side of the mihrab is the exquisitely decorated minbar where the imam stands when he is delivering his sermon. The mosque's layout ensures visibility and audibility of the imam for all attendees. The Sultan's Loge is an elevated platform situated in the southeast corner of the prayer hall. The platform has an L shape and is supported by 10 marble columns. It has its own mihrab with intricate decorations. Nearly 21,000 tiles with over 50 different designs, including cypress trees, flowers, and fruits in various colors like blue, green, red, black, and turquoise, grace the lower walls of this mosque. Painted motifs, arabesque patterns, calligraphic inscriptions, and Quran verses adorn the rest part of the walls. Natural light illuminates the interior section through 260 traditional windows, each intricately designed with colorful glass. Chandeliers suspended from the ceiling further brighten the prayer hall. In the topmost part of this mosque, the focus of the architecture is on the small and cascading semi-domes that harmoniously integrate with multi-tiered supported structures towards the summit of the central dome, towering at 43 meters on four massive cylindrical pillars. The courtyard of the mosque has three entrances, that the central one is on the northwest side, which opens to the external facade of the mosque. Above the gates to the prayer hall, there are small domes raised on drums. These monumental gates on the southeast side are decorated with muqarnas, in addition to the semi-vault structure and inscription panels. The courtyard has been built in a classic rectangular peristyle form, which includes an arcaded and domed portico. There are a total of 26 columns supporting the porticos and 30 domes above them. At the center of the courtyard, there is an octagonal domed kiosk sheltering a fountain that was used for ablution. The outer surfaces of the kiosk are carved with low-relief foliate motifs. Blue Mosque is distinguished as one of the five mosques in Turkey with six minarets that are fluted and capped with a slender conical spire. Each of the four minarets rising at the corners of the prayer hall has three balconies, while the others at the outer corners of the courtyard have two balconies apiece. Balconies are supported by corbels. These minarets historically were used to announce the religious call to the prayers. For this purpose, the announcer had to ascend a narrow spiral staircase inside the minaret five times a day. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Let me know your opinion in the comments section. And if you would like, please subscribe to my channel and wait for new videos.